day two of the Brian C. Campbell Memorial Christmas Hockey Tournament here from the JFK Coliseum. My name is Kyle Heavey, coming at you for day two of this wonderful tournament. We have the Manchester team facing off against the Goffstown Grizzlies. My name is Kyle Heavey from Manchester Public Television. It's been a pleasure to be with you. This is my third year doing this event, so it's kind of happy to be back here and see what type of hockey we can get here on this beautiful Monday afternoon here as the Grizzlies are all ready to go. Both teams get really pumped up here. Manchester lost a tough one yesterday. And now here we go. Face off one by Goffstown, but Manchester flying down. Parker Burgess with a quick shot. His centering feed goes around the net. Back to the defense. Defenseman for Goffstown falls down. Battle for it here. Manchester putting the pressure on very early. Backhand in speed. Push to the side. Fight for it in the corner. Got a stick on front. Shot. Blocks. It's still on front. Fight for it. Just goes wide of the net. Still picked up by Burgess. Back to the defenseman, shot, save wide. And now the Grizzlies still haven't been able to get it out of their zone. We even got line changes going on here. As we have Colin Fields coming onto the ice, replacing Burgess. Now coming out is Matt LaForge. Shot from the point. Their first goal, and that's not the way the Grizzlies were hoping to start this game, but for coaches Chuck Goss and Eric Fisher, they are pumped to see this. Some love right there to the goalie as well, Landon Wilson. Didn't have to work that hard. He has not seen any sort of goal in his area, or a shot in his area. Off one by Manchester. Now they're looking to keep the attack going. Down into the corner. Backhanded shot. Not sure if I heard a ting with the headset on. All the way down behind Wilson. A turnover there. Grizzlies quickly to take it, but easily seen there by Owen Kelly, able to get it out. No icing, says the officials underneath us. And now Manchester trying to get out. Turnover, Wilson was able to see it the whole entire way. Makes a blocker save, and now Manchester getting it out of the zone. Behind the net it goes. Our centering feed, oh, just to not be able to get the perfect amount of wood on that. And now a turnover, the Grizzlies trying to get something going. Pass a little too far. Now out of the zone. That might be it. Wilson holds on to it. And we'll get a faceoff in the offensive zone. Got a really fast 2 minutes and 32 seconds into this first period. Face off won by Manchester. Tries to clear it out. Finally does. Bounces out. Trying to feed it up to Parker Burgess. It's got to go for an icing though. And get the face off back in the Goffstown zone. First year for this Manchester team, a combination of all the high schools. Few from West, few from Memorial, bunch from Central. Shot there over the net. Goffstown still trying to fight for it. Goes around Wilson. tries to clear it out, and now some speed going into the zone. Manchester looking to add another one to the nice job by the defenseman there. The Grizzlies blocked it out. Supposed to be a centering feed. Good job, Joe Vallis. Getting physical down there. Centering feed, oh, just rolled off the stick. And now Grizzlies trying to get the momentum. Big collision in the middle of the ice. Just tempers starting to flare a little bit right there. Grizzlies did not appreciate that in front of their bench. Shot just wide. Picked up. Cleared out of the zone. Pushed back in. Manchester doing a great job in the neutral ice, getting the puck. Really fighting hard to. And finally, Goffstown is able to clear it out. Offsides is the call. But no one from Memorial or Goffstown touched it. And now we will get an icing down there. Come to the end of the ice. 10:35 remaining in this first period. 1-0 Manchester lead. Owen Kelly with the faceoff here. Lost. Goffstown takes it. Manchester having a tough time here. Goffstown put a little pressure on. Wilson lets it go flying by. Protected the goal at least. Now out of the zone it goes. It's good to see hockey with the NHL on a COVID delay. Winter break. Shot by Wilson. Almost squeaked over his pads and into the net. And out of the ice area it goes. Unfortunate. Dmitri Alexander was just trying to clear the puck out. Instead, it went over the glass. Short glass here at Gill Stadium. Or, excuse me, the JFK Coliseum. Gill Stadium across the street. Faceoff one. I tried it again. Oh, it somehow just stays in. Oh. Sides. We'll get it faced off right below us here. Thrown down. Drops out, able to take it. Burgess sends it down. It's going to go for an icing, though. Excuse me, that's Joe Vallis. Vallis, the freshman from Memorial. We got Aiden Kelly out there as well. Aiden gets the puck, goes around the net. Tries to pass it over to Vallis, to Burgess. We're not able to get it out of the zone. Now it is. And we'll see what they can do. Put the pressure on the Grizzlies in their zone. This is the first game we've been able to cover for this Manchester team, as the first game against Trinity was unfortunately postponed to New Year's Eve. Oh, a goal right there. Nice feed in front, and the Grizzlies tie it up 1-1. Goal at the 6:05 mark of this first period. able to tie up this game. And now Grizzlies looking to add some more. Snapshot, Wilson says, I got this. Off one by Manchester, passes around, flicks it out, but this might go for an icing. No, referees wave it off. Battle of the zone, it goes right in front to Kelly. Owen just not able to get it past the goalie, and now look at this, Grizzlies come the other way with some speed. Snapshot, covered up by Wilson, and we'll get a faceoff in the offensive zone. Manchester took the 1-0 lead easily. Now it's been a little bit more Goffstown with the pressure. One by the Grizzlies. Pass across, not able to make it. Manchester starting to play a little bit sloppy. No one's really trying to get the puck hard. Puck slithers out. And now a 2-on-1 chance for Manchester. Pass across. Oh, just not able to keep it on the stick. Back and forth hockey going on here. Game tied up. It's a weird redirect off the board. Around the net it goes. Looking to make something happen here. Aiden gets the puck. Passes it up. And now let's see what Manchester has here. Velez skating up. Look at this. Kelly goes short side. Not able to get anything. A great chance there, right there. Back behind the net. Aiden just gives it back to Wilson and says, all right, man, well, sorry about that. We'll get this figured out. Coaches underneath saying, someone step up. They know that they're not playing as well as they could be. And looks like Owen Kelly gets kicked out. Shot up the other way. And now, Aiden would get kicked out. Short side again, not able to get it past the goalie. Trying to make something happen. Pass to a defenseman. Winds up just wide. Still behind the net in the corner, trying to get something going. Goffstown coach yelling, move your feet. Here they come. Dimitri Alexander gives it up. Aiden passes it over. Gonna be an offsides, but Goffstown's gonna take and go the other way. Collision almost into the referee. Colin Fields, no mercy there. Doesn't matter if you're a zebra or you're wearing maroon. Shot. Worked for the first goal, 1:05 into the game. See what they can do again. Oh, that might be our first penalty in the game. No, never mind. No, referees decide to keep their arms down. And we have an offsides. Looked like Lucas Taff. So just a little bit over the blue line. And face off, won by the Grizzlies. Snapshot, Wilson lets it go by. Velez decides to Oh, that will go for an icing. That went right through the center of the rink. Coach Fisher not a happy man right now after seeing that. Faceoff in their zone. They had the energy for the first 4 minutes of the game, and now it's been all Grizzlies. But all that matters, the game is tied up. Max Ouellette with the faceoff for the Grizzlies. Lost. Collision right there. Even lost a glove. But going into the zone, shot! Over, just hits the glass. And a turnover here. Grizzlies still fighting for it though. And now Manchester gets the puck, passes it behind him. Still fight for it. And now the Grizzlies able to win it, come out. Shot here, off the post. Right to the glove side of things. Shot here, but it would have been offsides. Now it's clear. Deflected by the Grizzly. Still can't get it out of the zone. A shot there. Well done by Nicholas DiMarzio. Taking the opportunity with getting the puck. Manchester having a tough time getting the puck. It will not go for an icing this time, so we're able to get some line changes. Aiden Kelly, Parker Burgess, Colin Fields all out there. Puck slow rolls to the defensive, makes a move. Looking like Charlie McAvoy right now. Throws it in. There's not a Manchester jersey in sight though. Not able to keep it in. Aiden skates down. Up here. Joe Velez, that just barely hit the top of the stick for Gostown. That would have gone in for sure. Battle for it still. Aiden not able to keep it in. Gostown put a little pressure on in the zone. Flicks it over. Parker Burgess. Able to keep it going. Collision right there. Check of the body. Nice job by the Goffstown Grizzlies. Get that puck away. Back into the zone. Got a line change here from Manchester. With some fresh legs out there. Deflected there. Dimitri Alexander behind the net. Sends it out, but Gostown takes it. Wasn't sure if Wilson even saw that puck coming. Just went wide. And now Owen says, I'll take it, guys. Let's go. But still fighting in the neutral zone. It's a heck of a battle here. Good here for Manchester as they have been struggling to keep the puck. Face off won by the Goffstown. Turnover though, gets it out of the zone and a collision right there by Aiden Kelly. And now we got another penalty. Goalie hit comes off. Aiden's gonna touch the puck and we'll see what this call is. Things is a roughing on Aiden Kelly. So now it'll be a 5-on-3 for the next minute 42. There is only 1:01 remaining in this first period though. Face off won by the Grizzlies. this. Nice deflected shot. Passing over to this side. Defensive winds up, shoots. Wilson able to hold on to it and will get a whistle. This is going to be a tough one for a mixture of Parker Burgess, Joe Velez. And now sends it down to the other end of the ice. No one comes off here for Manchester. This is definitely the penalty kill line right here. Coming in with some steam, makes a move, shot, and a goal. A beaut right there for the Grizzlies. And with 28.6 seconds to go, they scored to take a 2-1 lead. He went far side on the goalie, and it was a heck of a move. That was a, certainly a beauty.
But he scored. You didn't step up, but he scored.
And that was, looks like it's going to be Brennan Pierce who's going to get that. Got a mixture of Owen Kelly, Mac Tripp, Colin Fields all out there, but it's still a 5-on-4 for the next minute and 22, as there's only 22 seconds remaining in this first period. Goffsavage coming around, right in front of the net, and now here we go the other way. Sent down, and we'll hear the last 5 seconds. Goffsavage with a possible chance for a long shot. Trying to get in, a collision mid ice, and that will do it for the first period here. Early lead for the Manchester team as they had a goal a minute 5 into the game, but Goffsavage has come back and will have the penalty for the last 59 seconds, the first 59 seconds of the second period. We'll take a quick break here from JFK Coliseum for the Brian C. Stone Memorial Hockey Tournament. I'm Kyle Heath with Manchester Public Television. We'll be back. Well, welcome back to period number 2 of game number 2 of day number 2 of the Brian C. Stone Memorial Christmas Hockey Tournament. The Goffsavage Grizzlies leading it 2-1 after the first. They still have 59 seconds to go on this penalty to Manchester, so they will be on the power play. As Aiden Kelly still sits in the box. Great to have fans in the stands here as well tonight. And you can hear the banging of the sticks. They're ready to go here for period number 2. Manchester scored first in the first period. They would like to do it again here in the second. And referee drops the puck. And now going into the zone here. On the penalty kill. But killed a couple seconds off the power play, that's all that mattered. Good face-off win. Chauvelez, Parker Burgess, all out there for Manchester. Shot. Stick side of the cage. Talked to Coach Fisher. He was not pleased with the way this team played the last 5 to 7 minutes of that first period. Someone had to step up, and no one has. Instead, here they are dealing with penalty issues. Apparently the same thing happened to yesterday's game, where that's how they were defeated. Shot goes out of the zone. Face-off at the center ice. 6 seconds to go on this power play for the Goffsavage Grizzlies. They're able to score on the 5-on-3. And now Aiden Kelly comes out of the box, but immediately comes off. Joe Velez gets the opportunity here. Going to be an offside. Smart move there by Lucas to realize that it was going to be offsides. Now the other way. Clear down. Shot from a distance. Deflected. We got Owen Kelly gets the puck. Shuddering feet and a goal! Just like that. Get the puck down low and make something happen. And Joe Velez gets the goal, the freshman, from Owen Kelly, and that ties the game up. A minute 32 into the second period. They scored early in the first, and now here they are scoring early in the second. That puck is being held onto here from the coaches. His first goal. And faceoff won by Manchester. Fight for it again. Velez centering feed, trying to give the favor back to Owen. Shot from behind the net. Centering feed, Owen in front. Not able to get it past the goalie. We got a grizzly down. And now here they come the other way. 2-on-2. Into the corner it goes. Goffstein has to wait to clear the zone. Shot just wide of the net. Goffstein doing all that they can. Coach is saying to ice it. Instead, look at this. Breakaway. Oh, what a save right there. Oh, and that should get a penalty. That's right. Power play for Manchester. Splendid opportunity right there by Lucas. He's upset at himself, but hey, there's now a 5-on-4 opportunity for Manchester. He's going to be looking at the replay of that. But sometimes in hockey, you got to have a little amnesia. Worry about it tomorrow. Or worry about today. Don't forget about it tomorrow. In their zone. Manchester already scored once early in this period. Let's see if they get another one. Shot in front. Hold on. Oh, it's not able to. Backhanded forehand. Try after try after try. And it's not able to get it. Centering. Oh, just not able to get it. And the Grizzlies get rid of it. Amazing job right there from the goalie, Ethan Santoro, to keep that puck from not getting past him. Now here we go. Aiden Kelly with some speed. Center feed. Velez tried to get it past. But a block. Nice pad save. Tripping was the penalty call. Still have 60 seconds to go on this power play. Back and forth it goes. Oh, now the Goffstein deflects it. Tries to get it past, but it was blocked away. And now centering feed. Goal! Aiden Kelly gets the lead back for the Manchester team on the power play. He sat in the box for the first 59 seconds of the second period, and now here he is, 3 minutes and 57 seconds into the second period, taking the lead. Apparently what Coach Fisher and Coach Goss said before this intermission has helped, as they have taken a 3-2 lead. Wow, Grizzlies. Gotta figure something out here. Puck has been in this zone the whole entire time. Parker Bird just skates around. Not able to get any contact with anything. Backhanded try. Not able to get it to anyone. Back trip comes back. And now, 2-on-2 try. Tries to go on the boards. Skating around. Nice backhand feed. Centerings. Aiden right there. Can it get past? Oh, the referees call a whistle, blow the whistle. faceoff will come in this zone here, but Goffstown able to get some fresh legs out there, including their top time, Lucas Ouellette, Max Ouellette, and Jay Clardy. See what Parker Burgess can do on the faceoff circle. He wins it. Bouncing puck. Try to clear, Aiden able to see it. Backhand feed on to the goalie, and he's gonna hold on to it. And we have a Grizzly player not doing so well, looks to be pretty shaken up. And that's Jake Clardy there, top centerman, trainer on his way out here. And we got a lot of the players, Colin Fields coming back. Able to get up on his own. He definitely don't want to assume what it is, but glad to see him okay. Seems to be coming back. And we got a face-off now. Too many men on the ice here for the Manchester. Owen Kelly loses the faceoff. Still in the zone though. Goffstown trying to get something going together. Not able to. Shot just wide of Santoro. Puck goes over the glass and will get a faceoff. Kind of deflected between the two players. Tate's coming off of the defenseman's stick. Run out of pucks soon, the way things are going. And now, Goffstown not able to get the passing going on. Owen gonna be offsides if they try to get in the zone. Able to get back. Nice cross ice passing here. Grizzlies trying to put something together. And gotta be held on to for a faceoff. The first time really the puck's been in this area of the ice besides some icings in some time. But Landon Wilson says, all right, guys. Puck drop, back it goes. Around the net it goes. Pass. Not able to make its mark, and goes to Goffstown. Battle of the neutral zone here. Both teams don't seem to want it. But now, look at this, Manchester coming to the zone. Velez. Shot, Wilson, let it go wide. Coming around the net, and now Velez. Line change here for Manchester. That's why there's no one over there. Burgess hoping for that pass, not able to do it. But now, quick move, ISO hockey here. Ends up on the stick of another Manchester teammate. Oh, shot over the net, deflected. Try to get it around, keeps it in the zone, oh. Not able to do a good job of snapping that. Gonna work on his form a little bit next time if he watches this tape. And that looks like it's gonna, should be a, yeah, we got a penalty for a hooking call. A shot. Goffstown with a 6-on-5 for the time being. Manchester not able to get possession yet. Now they do, and they will go on the power penalty kill again as Goffstown will get 2 minutes, a hook and call. And into the box will go Nick Duclos. well-known players here from Manchester doing some illegal things in the hockey world today. And, well, they're going to take some time to sit. But look at this. Manchester with a 2-on-1. Back in. Parker Burgess is not able to get that goal. Great speed. Great stick handling, but just great job there by Santoro to save it. And now let's see if we can do it again. Oh, not able to get it. Aiden had a chance there. Not much of a power play right now for the Goffstown, but right here on the doorstep and hit out of the zone and we'll get a line change. Owen Kelly being a little pest out there. Gets around. Aiden still out there. He's the only one that didn't change on that last changing of lines. Behind the net it goes. Still killing time. 60 seconds left on the power play. 6:47 remaining in the period itself. A 3-2 Manchester lead over the Goffstown Grizzlies. For Manchester Public Television, I'm Kyle Heavey. And down to the other end of the ice it goes. That will go as an icing on the Goffstown. Makes it interesting because now Goffstown can't even change their lines. Jake Clardy back out there against Owen Kelly. Kelly kind of tries to make a quick shot. Just goes wide. Just 30 seconds remaining on this power play for Goffstown. Gets it into the zone. Back in his shot, but cleared out of the zone. Goffstown looking to make something happen here. Gets it behind Wilson. Missed opportunity right there for the Grizzlies. And with 5 seconds to go on the power play, Manchester doing a good job of keeping the lead. I'm not sure what the referee saw, how it was offsides. He's explaining that to the player now. I was just as confused as Colin Fields on that. Parker Burgess out there, Colin Fields. Face off. Parker able to skate down and get the puck himself. Just a lackadaisical Goffstown team right there, thinking that there was no one coming for it. Great job by Burgess to say, hey, I'm faster than you guys. I'll take that puck if you don't want it. Manchester kind of coming the other way. Into the zone. Fields gets it kind of pickpocketed. Now the other way. 5 minutes remaining in the second period. A little bit of a hit to the back that knocked down a Manchester player. Now we got some collisions. Good solid checks going on. Into the corner. Goffstown with a better opportunity here than they did on their own power play.
Come on, boys, let's move.
Shot there from afar. Wilson lets it go wide. Manchester team playing pretty slow, but now here we go. 2-on-1. Oh, now comes a couple other players. Line change, perfect for a time for Manchester. Puck stolen. Can he get a shot? Saved right there. Knock it out of the zone. Looks like the Grizzlies need a line change at this point now. Ooh, almost open ice hit by Owen Kelly. Round. Net it goes. Goffstown trying to even up this game. They're getting some opportunities in their zone. Just nothing's getting by Wilson. goes wide. No icing. Perfect. Excuse me, ladies and gentlemen. And into the penalty box the puck goes. And we'll get a face-off. Center ice will go. Parker Burgess, Colin Fields line again out here. Back to the Grizzlies it goes. Shot. Deflected wide into the corner. Can it get out? It stays in the zone. We're finally able to get it going. Soft shot on net, though. Weird deflection. This puck is taking some weird bounces in this second game here. Parker Burgess, a little bit of a collision there, fell to the ice right in front of the Zamboni boards. Still fighting for it, and now out of the zone it goes. Right underneath me. Puck goes perfectly to Burgess, who sends it down. Now we'll get a line change. Matt Lessard out there now. Miss hit, Lessard. Forge as well. Ooh, a bit of a tussle there between a couple players. Dylan Elberg of the Grizzlies. We are under 120 seconds to go in the second period. Oh, big hit right there. And now we got Aiden Kelly getting hit in the back of the head. No penalty call on that. Manchester just trying to get it out of the zone. Couple players able to change out. No icing on that. Just a back and forth right here in the final 2 minutes of this period. Manchester doing all the scoring as now we'll get an icing with a 101 remaining. Ice 101, interesting. Down on the other end. Owen Kelly taking the face off. He's gonna get kicked out. Referee.
1 minute.
As you heard there, referee, official. Battle in this area, though. Coming around, Owen takes it. Seconds to go in this period, and no one going. Velez finally makes something of the puck, and now the puck goes over the glass. See what the referees are. Oh, we'll get a line change here. Aiden Kelly comes out there. Trying to get some offense. 16 seconds to go in this period. Trying to get one more goal. Face off won by the Grizzlies. All it takes is a turnover. As we saw on that second goal. Shot! Saved by Santoro. It's going to be sent the other way. And icing is called, but the buzzer sounds at the same time. And that will end the second period. Two early goals by Manchester, takes back the lead, 3-2. We'll be back after this intermission break here for more of the Brian C. Stone Memorial Christmas Hockey Tournament for Manchester Public Television. I'm Kyle Levy. We'll be right back. Well, we're ready to get back to the action here for the third period. Goffstown Grizzlies 2, Manchester 3. 2 goals scored in the second period have helped propel the Manchester team back into the lead. My name is Kyle Levy for Manchester Public Television. Do the commentary for the Brian C. Stone Memorial Hockey Tournament. The players are all loud and ready for this. 15 minutes off on the clock. And a face-off won by Goffstown. Puck goes high, scoring highs. I've never hit the speaker on the top of the JFK Coliseum here. Pretty high deflection right there to actually have that happen, so. The teams are getting ready to do this again. Parker Burgess wins it this time. Back to Aiden Kelly. Sends it back, Mac Tripp. Behind the net it goes. And now Goffstown with the fast skating. Not able to get that pass. Aiden doing a good job of pushing the player the other way. Kind of get him a little uncomfortable and worked out pretty well. Goffstown has capitalized on some lackadaisical type playing to score their 2 goals in the first. But Manchester has been hot to start the first and the second, so we'll see if things change here. Behind the net it goes. Ice is brand new, obviously. Zamboni was just on, so very slick. Oh, what a goal right there! That celebration deserves that. Owen Kelly goes high, glove side, over the shoulder, in between the crossbar. And look at that. Owen makes this a 4-2 game. Goffstown lost yesterday. This would pretty much mathematically eliminate them for being able to make it into the finals. Oh, a bit of a slew foot there. Up my way.
Owen Kelly, all alone.
Lots of love here. And for that, Nicholas DiMarzio. DiMarzio and Nick Duclos. And Duclos will get the penalty. Just an absolute stupid, right in front of your own box. Coach is able to see everything. And now we'll get a penalty, a power play for the Grizzlies. Referee's even talking to Coach Fisher. And now, roughing call, I'm thinking it's going to be. Cross-checking, okay. Well, minute 40 remaining. Manchester doing a pretty good job of stopping these power plays, but that's what the Central team had issues with last year. Oh, now look at this, a 2-1 run break. Parker Burgess, shot wide. Come around the other way now. Goes behind the net. Aiden Kelly able to get the puck. See what he does with it. Kind of fighting with it on the boards. And Aiden able to make something happen. Get out of the zone. Still keep the puck and send it down. 1 minute remaining on the power play for the Grizzlies. See if they can get something going. Down two goals. Three unanswered goals for the Manchester team. Wait for an offsides. Shot deflected off of Owen Kelly. Owen got to take it the other way. Tried to go to a backhand forehand. Instead, it took the bump. Now he seals the puck from behind the net. Tried to center feed it, but not able to do it. And now Manchester having a pretty good time on this penalty kill. And now we got a power play for the Grizzlies. Oh, excuse me, it was an offsides. I got excited. And with the last seconds ticking off, it's now 5-on-5. Grizzlies skating around, centering feed, centering in front still. Wilson tries to get it, takes it out of the air. Like he was playing catch on a warm, sunny day. 11:08 remaining in this game. Manchester leading it 4-2. Off one, but unable to get it out of the zone so far. And into the zone. Let's see what Manchester can do. Skates around, looking centering, but pushed away. Ugly pass by Goffstown. Puck goes back into the zone. Centering feet again. Both teams having trouble. But Manchester with a two-goal lead, obviously not as worried. Big hit right there. Now Grizzly falls on his... And we will get a tripping, I'm going to guess the call is going to be. Elbow. John McBride, Matt Osgood, and Matt Thompson telling his players to keep their mouth shut. It's now Duclos, who just spent 2 minutes in the box, spent another 2 minutes in the box, elbowing and cross-checking the two penalties that he's had. Face-off won by Goffstown, sent around the neck. Back trip, gets it, loses the puck. Centering feed, push aside. Good job by Aiden Kelly getting it out of the zone. Owen out there as well. And well done by Velez to get it out and back around. Goffstown comes in, snap it. Nice rip, but it not able to get past the goalie, and now down to the other end of the ice it goes. Goffstown, under 10 minutes to go in this game. And again, Manchester with some opportunities on the penalty kill. Centering feed, not able to make it happen. And Wilson, kick save out wide, taken. Trying to clear it out. Oh, nice job by Goffstown, keeping it in. Great effort right here. Big hit. Puck it's out. Max Ouellette doing a great job keeping that puck in the zone. Trying to make something happen, but with under 30 seconds to go in this power play for the Grizzlies. Off the glass, down the other end of the ice. Line change here for Manchester, and now we got a hit and a player down. Does not look good. Trainer is going to come out here. 8:27 remaining in this game. Got players getting away from. He's up on one knee, so that's good. Obviously, a play like that in the corner is never good, but Owen Kelly, obviously, an important player for this new Manchester team. He gets up, he's able to skate away. Good to see. Definitely felt that collision. Aiden giving some jokes to them. Not really safe for television purposes, but for the hockey world, it's always fun to rib you. Now we'll see. Les with the faceoff. Still only a few seconds remaining on this penalty kill for Manchester. And now with 8:15 to go in the game, 5-on-5 it is again. Duclos. Stick handling here. Shots. Oh. He's not able to. Gonna send it around again. And now Aiden winds up, rips it, but just goes wide. Goff sound. Running out of time. Icing's not going to help your team out as the puck comes down the other end of the ice now. Fight for it here. Into the corner goes. Centering feed. Nice job by Goff sound. Looking. Soft pass. Down behind the net it goes. Gets past Aiden Kelly. Actually kept it in the zone. My apologies. Looking to make some. Oh! Short side again. And the Manchester hockey team making themselves look dominant with four consecutive goals here and have now taken a 5-2 lead. Going short side over the shoulder. It's been impressive to see some of these goals. Colin Fields gets the goal. And now it's 7:08 remaining.
And that's the goal for by number 18, Colin Fields. Unassisted. And the goal, 7 minutes, 52 seconds. Fields.
Aiden passes it around. Goffstown just had the energy for the end of the first period, but ever since they've just not had it. And now we'll get a penalty on the Grizzlies. Already down 3 goals. And now I believe it's going to be a tripping call. Now the puck will come down the other end of the ice. Yeah. get the faceoff.
Marzio,
he was in that battle with Duclos earlier. Shot. Bad pass attempt there. Puck comes out of the zone. Six minutes remaining in this game. Manchester looking pretty dominant here with getting their first official victory. They lost to Windham the other day by a final score of 4-3 in overtime and were not able to win yesterday. Shot from the point. Wind up. Bouncing puck in front. Push aside. Still skating around with it though. Nice pass. Oh, give and go. Almost a backhand. Surprise shot. In the corner, looking. Letting his teammates move around. And a tough save. Good to see Owen Kelly back out here after that collision. Losing an edge. Pass across. Then it goes. 30 seconds still remaining on this power play for the Manchester team. Playing in their white jerseys. Oh, backhand shot. Just wide. Skating around. Stick lost. Oh, and give and go in front. Aiden looking for it. Now back to Owen. Owen winds up. It's in front. Cannot get it past. Oh, it goes across the crease. Aiden looking. Tries to pass it around. Kept in. And now we're on a 5-on-5. There. Oh. And 4 minutes remaining, and we will get an icing call. So, two players talking about what they got for Christmas there. It definitely is all love, as you can say. I hope they got an Xbox 5 and they're happy about it, but either way, we'll get a face off for the Manchester team in the zone. Offensive zone, and now getting kicked out. Cam DeBride getting kicked out. Going to see some of our younger players with a lead like this. Offside. Almost an offsides there. Oh! My good gosh. What a good job by Landon Wilson keeping that out. Shot blocked. Behind the net it goes. Goffstown really putting the pressure on. Out of the zone it goes. Not able to keep it in was Brandon Pierce, one of the goal scorers. Been some time since Goffstown scored a goal. Like to keep it that way. Shot there. Line change here. Owen Kelly able to come back out. Mac Tripp bringing it in. Shot just goes a little deflected into the netting. And now with 2:46 remaining in this game, Manchester opening it. Keep going further. It's been some tough teams as we have the Bill Falcons and Exeter Bluehawks coming up after this game. Both teams looked pretty dang good yesterday. And then later on we have Trinity, who are only playing with 10 players due to COVID, facing off against the Bedford Bulldogs. So there's a lot of hockey in 3 days here at the JFK Coliseum. including a girls' game tomorrow morning as well at 11 a.m. Centering feed, hits off the goalie. Now it's just a matter of, is there any bad blood from this game that's going to boil over? Manchester with a 5-2 lead. Shot, save, goal! Just like that, Chauvelez, his second of the day, and that easily puts the game at hand. 6-2 lead with a minute 54 to go, and this Manchester team, all smiles right now. You can hear the celebration below us. Yeah, but they obviously, you've got to keep this tournament going. Another face-off. Fight left. Back trip with the assist. Goffstown with an opportunity. Shot, save wide. Off the glove. Landon Wilson almost lost the stick there, let it go wide. Goffstown not feeling so hot with this. Got a lot of the younger guys that are new to hockey out there.
1 minute in the period.
And 1 minute left in the game. Aiden Kelly takes it, does a little move. He's gonna skate up with it with his long stride and long stick. Into the zone he goes, still looking. For a lackadaisical type play, it actually worked pretty well. Oh, offsides right there. Micah Huffman, the junior here, the big fall. Seems they're going to give him a little hard love for. Sent into the zone. Behind the net it goes. 20 seconds remaining in the game. Puck's going to come all the way down. No icing, they're saying. Officials decide that the game out of hand, there's just no point in having another face-off. Manchester comes down to the in their zone. And with the buzzer sounding, Manchester gets their first victory. The players come down and celebrate with Landon Wilson. And congratulations to Manchester for winning their game here on the second day of the Brian C. Stone Memorial Hockey Tournament. Good luck to the Goffstown Grizzlies, as we'll see them possibly tomorrow. We'll have more games today. I know that Daryl Johnson has just come up here, and he'll be continuing the next game with Bowen Exeter, Battle of the Birds here. But some appreciation from both sides. I'm sure they'll face each other down the road again. They can learn from each other. But for game two of day number two, Manchester wins it 6-2. We'll be back with more at the Brian C. Stone Memorial Hockey Tournament. For Kyle Heavey, we'll see you soon.